doubles gold medal match. Jiske Griffiun, the singles champion and the woman she beat in the final, and Aniek and KOOT against their fellow Dutch women, Marjolein BUIS and Diede GROOT. BUIS, a winner of the gold medal in 2012 with Esther Begeer. And here are Griffiun and KOOT preparing for a match they'll be playing with each other. They are regular partners, of course. Griffiun beat Van Kurt in the gold medal match, but they've been playing together for so long that those sort of rivalries and issues are very much part and parcel of sport and this sport, so no issues at all. Marjolein BUIS and Diede Groot. Groot just 19, playing in her first Paralympic Games, and what an opportunity for her. Well, the Dutch have such a strong, deep tradition, legacy in this sport, particularly in the women's side, with Esther Begeer, one of the, well, perhaps the greatest wheelchair tennis player of all time, having retired. But the next generation are certainly making their presence felt here.
Definitely. Yeah, I mean, you've got the youngster, yeah, Diede Groot, as you say there, and these two have got nothing to lose. You know, they can play with real freedom. I mean, I'm sure if someone had offered Diede Groot in particular a silver medal before these games, she would have taken it, but has the chance today to steal a gold against the experienced duo of Griffiun and Van Kuyt, who, well, they did the Grand Slam of Grand Slams in 2013. They won all four of the Slams in that year. 11 Slams coming into this competition before. They've had so much success together, and they are the strong favourites for this one. And Griffiun, having won the gold in the singles, she's also finished world number one 5 times before at the year end in doubles. And so it's going to take something special from these two, but you do just never know when the pressure's on. We saw Griffiun start that singles final against Van Kuyt a little nervously and open the door to Van Kuyt, and she couldn't quite take it. It finished 6-4 on the third, of course, but nerves are a strange thing. And as I say, these two can just play with real freedom out there and just enjoy the experience, and you never know where that will take you.
Also, Pete Hodges sitting alongside me as the players roll out for the toss. Tails it is, and Griffiun and Van Kuyt win the toss, and Joe Craig, the umpire for this gold medal match, will take to her chair as the players roll out to warm up. Nice warm applause. Well, the Dutch really are just phenomenal. It's the third successive Paralympics, and it's an all-Dutch women's doubles final. Of course, Griffiun has a gold medalist, the world number one, has yet to win a gold medal in the doubles, so that's something she wants to put against her name. She lost the final in London, playing together with Van Kuyt against BUIS and Begeer, and then in Beijing, lost the final playing with Esther Begeer, which couldn't have been easy. A woman who wins everything all the time, Esther Begeer, in those days.
I think that's her only ever Paralympic loss, yes, as well for Begeer, so it was not something that Griffiun wanted, and that was another reason why I think there were nerves yesterday in that final, because, you know, that was an opportunity that she would have looked at and thought, I should have won gold on that occasion. Is it going to happen again where I lose in the final when I'm expected to win?
Emily Kazin, Shelby Barron, and then Lucy Schuker and Jordan Wiley, the two combinations that have been put aside on their route to the final. Well, they are a formidable combination, and the left-hander Van Kuyt is perhaps the more emotional, more expressive of the two, and she's perhaps a little more expressive on the court as well with her racket. That left-hander's forehand is a very dangerous weapon. Marjolein BUIS and Diede Groot, Anna Mathewson and Katen Verfruth, and then Yu Kimiji and Miho Nijo. Kimiji is a player who is a bit of a thorn in the flesh for Jiske Griffiun, in particularly in doubles, that is, through this year. She's been on the losing end of a Kimiji doubles match 4 times this year, Jiske Griffiun, and Kimiji has played with a variety of partners, but most successfully with Jordan Wiley of Great Britain. She's not in this final, neither is Jordan Wiley. And Diede Dufrit and Marjolein BUIS, 28-year-old BUIS, is a gold medalist from London. Diede Dufrit, the only one here who hasn't got a Paralympic medal, because this is her first Paralympic Games.
Yeah, and going back to the point of Kamiji having success, it was Kamiji and BUIS who won the Australian Open title, beating GRIFFIOEN and Van KOOT this year. And they haven't been quite as dominant as they usually are, GRIFFIOEN and Van KOOT. I mean, it's to show just how strong they are when you're talking about reaching slam finals but not winning them. They were runners-up at both the Australian Open and at the French Open. As I say, runners-up to BUIS, so she has beaten the pair in a big match already in 2016. And she also won Johannesburg, two tournaments there with Kamiji. Kamiji also paired up with the GROOT, so she has indeed sort of been around and played with lots of different players, but had lots of success. She won the Tokyo Toyota Open with De GROOT, who's also won three tournaments away from playing with BUIS. Together, they've reached a lot of finals this year. They're up in Pensacola and the Cajun Classic, as well as the BNP Paribas Open de France, where they lost to GRIFFIOEN and Van KOOT. But they haven't had a lot of success when they've come up as a duo against GRIFFIOEN and Van KOOT. They've lost three times already this year, and all of them have been in straight sets. So they're going to need to try and do something a little different today. Gold medals around the necks there. I think they're real.
Yeah, I think you probably find those proliferating around the grounds. So the Olympic Tennis Center, and it is center court action in the women's doubles final. And an all-Dutch final once more in the women's competition. Jiske GRIFFIOEN and Aniek van KOOT against Marjolein BUIS and Diede Dufrit. So we know gold and silver are going to the Netherlands in the doubles. They've already done so in the singles. Remarkable how they dominate the women's wheelchair tennis front, but not quite the men's. One man, Mikael Scheffer, is inside the top 10 in the men's rankings. But much must be to do with the remarkable success of the specific year.
Yeah, and of course, heavily connected to GRIFFIOEN, as Esther Vergeer, from the same town in Woerden. And also, like Vergeer, GRIFFIOEN was a wheelchair basketball player before switching to concentrate on wheelchair tennis. Now, like Vergeer, is also a gold medalist in the singles.
Yeah, I think lots of similarities between tennis and wheelchair basketball in terms of mobility and moving and changing direction very, very quickly. And quite a few players have made that migration from wheelchair basketball to wheelchair tennis.
Dylan Alcott.
Yeah, most notably,
this year.
Gold medal in both sports.
Yes, an achievement. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see today who they look to attack. Of course, Van KOOT has struggled a little with her serve throughout the tournament. Had 23 double faults in the semi-final. Had a number of double faults as well in the final. She is a player, though, who really does like to attack, particularly with the forehand side. So they'll be looking to keep it away from that wing of Van KOOT, trying to get her to hit as many backhands as possible. But GRIFFIOEN's pretty rock solid. She'll be probably looking to set the point up for Van KOOT. And so that is the challenge today for BUIS and De GROOT.
And there's young Diede Dufrit.
Had an excellent singles competition as well at De GROOT. Brilliant win over Jordan Wiley in the quarterfinals. Didn't quite get herself a medal. Very nearly, though, beat GRIFFIOEN in the semi-finals. She is going in the right direction, as I say, only 19 years of age. And this is a match that hopefully she'll be able to just enjoy. She's guaranteed a medal. Already some achievement. And, nothing to lose today against the red-hot favourites, really, in GRIFFIOEN and Van KOOT.
Nice couple of serves. Get the warm-up completed. And one thing we have seen in this Olympic Tennis Center is a really great support for the wheelchair tennis. It's been one of the hallmark events throughout the Paralympic Games here. The level of play has been out of this world. It really has been top draw.
It's been phenomenal. You feel that the sport is just going from strength to strength. We've seen a lot of the aggressive tennis and the positive tennis, which is winning the medals as well, which I think is only a good thing for the sport because it just means it's that much better to watch. You're able to see the players really attack at speed. There's a quality women's singles final as well between these two. Full of drama, full of twists and turns and winners.
Yes, Jiske GRIFFIOEN to serve first in the women's doubles final.
Also will be nice for the group. I think she's playing with such an experienced player in BUIS. Because you know, she's won a gold medal before, so she'll have some guidance to the left of her.
Just a little too long. Yeah, and yeah, she, I think she'll need that just to initially just to settle down. And there's nothing like, I'm sure, playing a match like this, a big final. No matter how experienced you are, there will be some nerves. We saw it from GRIFFIOEN yesterday in the singles final. A couple of errors from GRIFFIOEN, just the nerves expressing themselves in those errors. For now, it'll settle. You can see the tension in her shoulders there, almost. Just 3 points for the game. Backhand, and BUIS deciding to take it on the first bounce. Didn't quite work out for it. First game, GRIFFIOEN and GROOT.
This is it. Who do you hit to? These two. Go to Van Koot. To get a thunderous forehand coming back over the net. If you go to GRIFFIOEN, you're not going to get many cheap points.
They've only went to a forehand once in that game, and GROOT responded with a pretty impressive forehand of her own. BUIS to serve.
At the moment, they need a little more to BUIS. So, of course, Root has had an excellent tournament in terms of the singles. They're mixing it up, going down the middle quite a bit as well. BUIS would probably just be saying to just to try and enjoy this one and get her to relax as much as possible.
Super play from BUIS, who came in behind that forehand and was able to execute the backhand volley.
You tend to play your best tennis when you are enjoying it. Heard about that. BUIS enjoying that movement. First time really we've seen them be aggressive. Oh. see it once more. Having the success at the front of the court. Tried to take it on the first bounce there. Players always want to do. You want to take it as early as possible, but just misjudged it a little.
She's a nervous start, no question. Diede GROOT at the moment. Two break points.
GRIFFIOEN come forward too often. She's a player who likes to stay around the baseline. She's very consistent, very solid off both wings.
Calling for it all on her backhand, but GROOT was arranging, waiting for potentially unleashing that big forehand of hers. Break point save, good rallying from Diede GROOT there. That'll give her some satisfaction. A little glimpse of a smile there from the 19-year-old.
You feel they're warming up.
Yeah. 3 points in a row, they've won here now from two break points down.
GRIFFIOEN and Vancouver, and they've lost them comfortably too.
Won the last three between the two pairs, GRIFFIOEN and Vancouver.
After that, it's so significant in the start of a match. Mm. You go behind early, start thinking, here we go again. Get on the board here. This is an important game.
Got to really come into the net. It might look like a wild miss, but you really have to be so accurate with it, because you miss it by half a foot and your opponent can chase it down. Thank you. changed momentum when he went to the from KOOT forehand and then the deep backhand from Griffiöen.
Momentum into the ball, exposing the backhand side of Van KOOT. Going up the middle of the court in the order of the day for a base group, because particularly with the way that they are, that's where both of their backhands are. Griffiöen and Van KOOT, but Van KOOT is a lefty, so it cuts out the angles. A bit of a joy out of that. Just overcooking it on that occasion.
Great volley, came in behind it, the return, and moving swiftly across to the centre of the court.
Just knocked down the back of the ball a bit, skidded on the surface a little bit more. Ensured that the group was always stretching.
She lined up that forehand, waited for the second bounce to really get it right.
That's a body blow, I have to say, to BUIS and to GROOT. They play some good tennis in that game. At the end of it, it is Griffiöen and Van KOOT who are able to get the break.
This is not the sort of start that BUIS and GROOT were hoping for here. Yeah. They knew it was going to be tough. Aniek van KOOT to serve at 2-love. You see her eyes light up when it comes onto her forehand there from KOOT. What she wanted to do, and just couldn't execute, blocking her forehand in the net.
Going in the middle of the court, and getting some joy out of it. I feel that Van KOOT serve is will look to attack. Of course, they'll probably get a fair few cheap points as well with the double faults she usually throws in.
Yeah. Well played. Her first winner. That'll give her plenty of confidence.
It is an effective forehand. Used this superbly well against Wiley in the semi-finals. Quarter-finals, I should say. Chance for Van Kooten on that occasion.
Three chances to break back. Base in the Groot, base to receive from Van Kooten. You could almost see that happening with Aniek van KOOT. Middle match it is of the women's doubles. Jiske GRIFFIOEN and Aniek van KOOT have just dropped serve in the case of van KOOT. It's all with serve though in the first three games. Start to this doubles gold medal match. One player hasn't served yet. The Groot is about to do so now in the fourth game. She and Marjolein base have just broken to make it 1-2.
Tactic, keep using it up the middle time and time again. They're refusing to give either of GRIFFIOEN or Van Kooten the forehand to swing at.
There's many nuances about this game, wheelchair tennis. We've seen it now from Jiske GRIFFIOEN in the last 2 points. It's pacing yourself and judging your roll into the ball to pick it up either on the first or the second bounce. The previous point she lost, she didn't quite get that timing right. And it's a miscue. And stability in the serve, very, very difficult. Just keep the chair dead still.
Well, it's also important after you hit the serve to get rolling quickly, to get the momentum so you can then get on the move. So important on the serve to try and, particularly in women's tennis, to try and neutralize the point. Make sure that that return isn't coming back and making you stretch or making you have to move too far.
Drop shot from the baseline.
Of course, this is another point for chair tennis. You have two bounces. When you go for a delicate shot like a drop shot, it's got to be so, so close to the net. And that was just magnificently played by BUIS. Good chance for Van Kooten. Just a nasty collision happening there.
Worked their way out of a spot of bother there, facing the crew quite well. Double fault in the game for 19-year-old Diede de Groot. That's just six doubles matches this year, Diede de Groot. 122. But up against the other three players in the court, she's very inexperienced. 78 matches won in her career. That you see so seldom.
In the right position, forehand, just so it's been a really good response. The underdogs, they are the second seed, so that bigger underdogs. Not a breakdown. Certainly making Van Koot and Griffiøen think about when they're playing their tennis. And those double faults need to stop.
If they do. You've made a point in the previous service game about Aniek van Koot and about her double faults, and it is a legitimate point because she won a match earlier this tournament.
23
double faults, and still managed to win it. Speaks volumes for the rest of her game, but do that in a final like this and think he'd get away with it. And yeah, van Koot served three in this game. Oh dear. So, Griffiøen and Van Koot with the break back and lead 3-1. Three service breaks in the first four games. Jiske, Griffiøen and Aniek van Koot will lead by 3-1.
Yeah, you have to say, when the ball's been in play, it's really been tested, the top seeds. Fortunate there. That game with four double faults. So often these big matches, it's all about managing emotions that react to adversity. The different situations that you're going to be put in.
Yeah, good serve. Gave no room at all into the body in the end, and having to just try and scoop the ball over the net didn't work, and it's 15 up. Gotta get her head up. That is a super response to the big forehand. Well played, Diede Groot.
Fantastic winner. That is the other danger of coming forward to the net. You do leave yourself a little exposed. Griffiøen well out of position there, and no chance for Van Koot to cover.
In the middle of the court so efficiently.
And even though these two have got a lot of experience and a lot of matches together, a lot of Grand Slam titles too, if you can get it right in the right place, you're still going to cause confusion between the pair.
Jiske Griffiøen strong at the net, holding her place and backing herself to put it away. She did.
Yeah, didn't do too much with this volley, as you can see there. Just timed the roll to perfection. And lovely hand skills, just angling the racket, letting the ball doing the talking, locking it away.
In.
Yes. I think Bates will be annoyed with herself there. Turn back in play. She was trying to do, obviously, pin these two back, kicking the backhand. Just feel that these two are winning more of the bigger points.
She had some beautiful shots in that rally, Diede.
Well, this was the issue for her against Kimiji in a singles bronze medal match. You know the power that she has. She likes to play an aggressive brand of tennis to Groot, but sometimes just loses the balance, knowing when to just slow it down again and be patient. Come with experience, though, no doubt. To see her being so positive. Contagious, isn't it?
Yeah, and she's struggled from that court, hasn't she? So now, again, it's Bason de Groot. Salvage something here and bring it back to 2-3.
Just feel they're a little stronger when they're that way round, Griffiøen and Van Koot, because yes, it means they have the forehands down the middle of the court. A little more solid. Keep seeing at base and the group going down the middle of the court. Able to dominate the point no more, the top seeds.
Out. Yeah, you think that maybe try and engineer to switch over a bit more often and settle the rhythm of this pair. At the moment, it's a little ding-dong this game. Neither side able to really close it out and take the initiative.
Hey.
at last they do close it out. And it was hard work for this pair, Griffiun and Van Kurt, the top seeds. They now lead by 4-1 in this women's doubles gold medal match.
Worry a little for BUIS and De Groot. They've not played badly, but how often do you see it? You get the top seeds and a pair that have won so many matches together playing against a pair that they know well, and they're the pair that always win the big points. And that's what they've done. The juice game's almost going the way of Griffiun and Van Kuut. That's a play, it feels like it should almost be leveled, but yet the mountain to climb in this opening set now.
It does look like that, and neither side really has played outstanding tennis to take that 4-1 lead at the moment for Kurt and Griffiun. 19, now 20 unforced errors from this pair, and that 4-1 fault in a game really does hurt.
It's incredible when you do look at the stats. Van Kuut, you know what their game plan is. They've hit one winner, 4-1 up. This is where, again, coming back to the bronze medal match for De Groot, she got a little frustrated when she wasn't able to hit through her opponent, Kimiji. And it's being able to react and think, okay, what the opponents are doing, not to get worried if you fail to achieve what you're trying to do over here.
She's looked for too much.
Great rally, more like it. As I say, they've got to stay patient. Take a lot of shots to break these two down. They've done a lot of good, as well as a few bits of unforced errors here and there.
Just the game's not firing, is it? She knows it can. 5-1 beckons for Griffiun and for Kurt. Not yet, though.
Okay.
knocks it out of court, hands on her head, and they slip to 1-5 in the first set against the top seeds. Jiske Griffioen and Aniek van KOOT now in control of this first set, 5-1, and it'll be van KOOT to serve.
Good timing, it's just been off a little.
Targeting for the KOOT for sure. Not much BUIS can do when that happens.
It's almost a case of over-trying the KOOT. Can you just maybe put down to a bit of experience?
Better.
It's important for her to not to get too high when she hits the winners and too low when she doesn't win the point. Understand how to react to certain situations. She's a little down after missing a few balls.
There it is, the boom out and the forehand from van KOOT. It's the first winner we've seen from that weapon of hers.
It's taken its time, but what a shot this was. Leaning backwards, generating the angle, but also generating plenty of power.
Look how high she hits it, just above head height. Amazing. Such a good forehand from van KOOT at the baseline. Low over the net, and she knew Griffin would have a tough task making that backhand. It was dipping over the net. Well played. Gives Griffiøen and van KOOT a set point at 5-1.
So far. Quality hitting from van KOOT. A few awkward positions there, but able to adapt her body to keep the ball back in play. Too many errors really in this opening set from de Groot and BUIS. Simple as that. Just trying to force the issue too much.
That's out.
Clever shot placement from base.
She identified what the crowd's going through here. I'm sure that when she was playing with Esther Fakir, she would have been the targeted player.
To think that it is De Groot who's the targeted player, just because she did the singles, you know, she is a top player. It is the difference of experience. Space having won a gold medal before. This, first final of the Paralympic Games for De Groot.
So close, and there was the Groot in a little hitting match with GRIFFIOEN. That's well played, confidence building that. Marjolein base and Diede de Groot holding on, fighting hard here against Jiske, GRIFFIOEN and Aniek van KOOT. They saw off a couple of set points in that game. Jiske, GRIFFIOEN there, and Aniek van KOOT with a 5-2 lead. Can the pair of BUIS and De Groot continue their mini fight back here? They held off some set points in the previous game. De Groot to serve. First point.
I think their last game important, even though they may not be able to come back in this set. Just to stop the momentum against them. Some belief and confidence in the second set. So frustrating. Whenever you feel a bit of momentum themselves, here comes a double fault, it just stops it. She's had four double faults in her last service game.
Back to type up the middle. To the respective backhands of GRIFFIOEN and van KOOT. This time van KOOT sailing it over the back.
One of the reasons we have seen so few winners as well from GRIFFIOEN and van KOOT is because of the reason of where BUIS and De Groot have hit their balls down the middle, given their opponents angles or opportunities to open up the court. tactic in that respect has worked. There's just too many errors.
Yeah, she hits her serve to the deuce court so beautifully the last couple of points. Nice, crisp and firm, and drawing the error there from Griffiun. But she served two double faults from the ad court. That's better.
Aware here, the top seeds, that right in the balance, they weren't able to close it out here.
Yeah, they don't want to have to come out and serve again to try and close out the set, so they can do it here. That's another excellent serve.
Tends to throw the ball at the right hand side, which I think just helps her out with cutting around it. It seems to be a little easier to do from the deuce court side.
Very good pace as well. Played, the court will be very comforted by that. First hold for Diede de Groot in this match. Griffiun and van Kuurt to lead 5-3. And they'll serve for the set once more. This time for Jiske Griffiun.
She's the player who's yet to be broken. They're on the court who has that record.
Double fault. There's a breeze swirling around centre court. Consistency from the Groot again.
She loves to take risks with the forehand. Just wonder in 4 years' time in Tokyo how big that forehand's going to be.
Well done, sending her back into the forehand corner.
No momentum into the ball there whatsoever, the Groot's clever tactics. These two. Clever initially from Griffiun with the high forehand, just to allow time for van Kuurt and Griffiun to get into position, but haven't got themselves back into the point. It's a bit of a surprising error.
They're from the other side of the court. It's deciding this match, but it's not being decided either way at the moment. And it's a chance for a 6-3 first set situation for Kiffian and for KOOT. She sprayed it wide. What a good rally. How well did De Groot in base play, but De Groot particularly of that chase down. Brilliant. Look at this.
What a get that was. So close to being a third bounce. She almost toppled over as well, but fabulous speed from De Groot. And they hung in there, hanging in there in this set. So often it happens in able-bodied tennis when you have a very long rally, the next point is usually below 3 points. Remember, there's a statistic on it all that long ago. It's fascinating. You go after using all that effort, set point again.
Around the backhand to try and take it on her favorite forehand. Back to deuce.
Targeting the glute there, actually exposing the backhand.
Still feeling about the music and the samba going on next door. It's five-a-side football just next door on the court number one. There's quite an atmosphere, a vibe going on there. And it's another set point here for Griffiöen and for KOOT.
See KOOT just reeling away there and talking to herself because doesn't really need to go for it. There's been a number of errors from De Groot, and you just feel if she can keep the ball in play, then another error is probably around the corner. A real battle this opening set. That's a fine return.
Yeah, rare winner. We've seen very few. I was glad to say this, well, that being said, has been characterized by a few errors, unforced errors, but that is a cracker, and it sets up a breakback point. It's a twist here in this first set. Yeah, there's an excellent forehand. Usually she goes across court with it.
Yeah, I think they were expecting to get a de Groot again. Catching base by surprise. Super strike.
They work so hard, aren't they? It's deuce. Oh. Yeah. She has got a beautiful forehand as well and makes it work perfectly.
Can be a little hit and miss, but when she catches it right like this one, it's not coming back. Whipping over the ball there. Short action on that occasion and generating the angle.
And there is another twist in this match. It is 5-4. Jiske Griffiøen and Aniek van Koot have just dropped serve. And it's back on serve. They were leading 5-1. The number one seed not able to close out this first set. They've lost three games in a row from 5-1, base to serve. Won't get there. Lovely soft volley from this 28-year-old BUIS, who's a gold medalist in the last games, but that was playing with a great Esther Vergeer. So, good start as they look to level at 5-all. Thank you. It is such a weapon, her forehand. And it lacks the consistency to be a match-winning one at this stage. So tricky.
Windy out there as well.
Yeah, you can see the wind. Yeah, because it really is difficult. Yep, she can't get it. Deep breath. Disappointing on the backhand. And KOOT and KRIFFIOEN have two more set points. They were 5-1 in this set. Can they close it out here? And it's a beautiful serve.
A slice on the ball there, cutting it away.
So the set point now and a second serve. Shot from the far side of the court. KRIFFIOEN and KOOT eventually taking the set. But my word, they made hard work of it. 65 minutes, they've taken it 6-4.
Tight first set, full of drama, but maybe the quality of it was lacking at times. A few too many unforced errors in particular from BUIS and de Groot, 37 in total from them. They were the aggressors. And, KRIFFIOEN and KOOT just said, look, try and beat us, try and break us down. They'll want to cut out the unforced errors as well. 29 in total to go with just two winners. But despite those stats, it's the top seeds who have taken the opening set by 6-4.
Prolonged break between sets one and two due to players just taking a comfort break. And this pair will be pondering a few things. One of them will be to cut down on the unforced errors. And there's an incredible vibe in this arena, in the centre court. Those two players will be looking to cut down their unforced errors as well. And that vibe in the centre court has been enhanced by the arrival of a living Brazilian sporting legend in Gustavo Kuerten.
Yeah, great player. Fantastic player he was.
Yeah.
And they love him here in Brazil. Guga, Guga. His name is Guga.
And he's come to watch this final, which is wonderful. And there's a bit of a distraction going on in the stands. Umpire Anya Frigg just asking for a bit of calm. Start of the second set, Aniek van Koot to serve. In this women's doubles final, she and Jiske Griffiøen have taken the first set 6-4 over Marjolein and Diede de Groot. Decision there.
Interesting to see just how they are early on in this second set. They lost lost all their momentum. Of course, they were 5-1 up in the first set. Ended up scraping over the line. They said on a deuce game, 5-4. So I feel they could play a lot better. I think they'll continue to play a similar brand of tennis, of just consistently putting the ball in, testing out Diede de Groot as much as possible. Just waiting, maybe, if, you know, Bass and de Groot get themselves ahead in this set, then maybe Griffion and KOOT will to be a bit more positive with their play. Two winners in that first set, they still won it.
She got the record onto it, which is all that matters, and it went over.
I'd say maybe deserved a bit of luck here, as it was coming in pretty quickly. Very quick reactions to get a racket down in time. Off the frame, but nonetheless, take it. Thought he'd lost the game. There you go. Just momentary lapse in concentration. She'd dropped the ball behind her, is ready to change ends. You're just saying, no, we're still in this game. Yeah,
don't give it away that easily. Let's look, these two have two break points based on the GROOT.
Change ends a little early.
Double fault, and the GROOT and BUIS take the break in the first game in the second set. 1-5 down in the first set, fought back and make KOOT and GROOT work really hard to close out that set. Just feel that they're one step away from being a little more decisive, a more controlling role in this match. A good hold here by Diede GROOT will go some way towards getting him in that position.
Do you feel that Griffin and Van Kuyt have been so passive, just allowed to get on top of this match? It's a different psychological battle though for BUIS and GROOT now that they're ahead.
And the errors are flying from the top seeds rackets. BUIS and de Groot to make them hit more balls, get them into the rally and play their game. And turn the tactics around. Good start to the game though for de Groot.
Vicious slow slice. A bit of confusion. Done that to their opponents pretty well, going down the middle. Time getting a taste of their own medicine.
just kept coming into it. A slice, little cut around the ball.
And he just couldn't get back in time. He didn't judge that the spin and the side spin on the ball.
What they need to do.
This shot is so tough to execute. This was a wonderful high backhand. Just a flick of the wrist, that's awesome.
Strong wrists. And she was quite far from the net as well, so it was difficult. Well done. 30 all.
Just come along at times when you've just thought, what a great point. Bit of momentum again, and it stops. Double fault.
Position there, both had to reach. Back of parity at one all. 2 breaks to serve for the start of the second set.
It's a strange final though at the moment. I really feel that Griffiön and KOOT have done that much. Putting the ball in play a little bit more than their opponents.
Recovery in the back of the court here. This shot, brilliantly played. Timing there from KOOT, just missed the second bounce.
She got caught in two minds with whether to stretch and take it on the first bounce or then to try and get a bit more pace on the half volley. Ended up being just a fraction behind it. Just shows that how easy these players make it look in terms of how often they roll into the shot time and time again.
Beautifully played. Been few winners from KOOT and KOOT.
just the third. Kicked it low over the net, took the time away. No chance for base to react to it. He knifed down the back of the ball.
More dynamic there from KOOT.
I think they've just upped the pace a little bit. They're looking to take the ball a fraction earlier. So the initiative back. They've lost it momentarily, no doubt about that. Lost it four out of the last five games before the last one.
Free point gives them the game. Hold serve, make it 2-1 in the second set, having taken the first over BUIS and the KOOT, their fellow Dutchman. Aniek van KOOT and her partner Jiske are a set and 2-1 up in this women's doubles final, the wheelchair tennis at the Rio Paralympic Games. Marjolein base to serve. Side of the court as well. 15-all.
All players will know each other very well. It's off the court. Not always easy playing against friends and teams that you know so well. You know each other's weaknesses. So a lot of pressure and expectation, particularly on GRIFFIOEN and KOOT.
Two very good overheads, the second one exceptional.
Tough shot to execute that one. He's got herself side on so she could generate the speed. Good movement.
Yes.
there's been a lot of unforced errors. It's been intelligent play. They've probably looked at the history in terms of the amount of wins that they've had. And pretty much just said their opponents, right, break us down. We're going to make you play a lot of balls. See if you have the belief to go on and take the gold. And at the moment, it's quite there for the GROOT and BUIS.
And that's a very quick game. It's gone the way of GRIFFIOEN and KOOT, give them a 3-1 lead. And they're nicely positioned here, are GRIFFIOEN and KOOT in the final of the women's doubles.
Yeah, just up the speed a little bit, they've been taking the ball a fraction earlier. Different spins on the ball as well. It's unsettled the GROOT. Make mistakes.
Seven double faults each side. Serve.
The smash there, the moving slice smash, an improvisational shot. Regretting it now, though, pushed it long.
That's the sort of thing they must try and do. It didn't work, but they've got to try something here. They are a set now, verging on 4-1 down. They're not that far behind. You just feel that they need to try and change up the game, change something here. Make GRIFFIOEN and KOOT win the match.
That's it, isn't it? You go ultra-conservative, you start just going back down the middle and say, right, come on, come out of your shell, GRIFFIOEN and KOOT. It seems to me that they almost just can't keep the ball in as long and rally it out. All the unforced errors haven't been on shots where they've been going for the winner.
Yeah.
It's just been routine balls. So at least with that one on the previous point, it was a shot that was, so we would have got them to win the point. So that's the other way that they can go, just be more aggressive. Give GRIFFIOEN and KOOT something different to look at.
Thank you. There we go, well played. Base at the net.
They were doing exactly what we said they needed to do, give them a different look, something different as well, and drew both Griffiøen and Van Koot into the net. Got them the point.
The game. We managed to rally that one out. Base in the Groot pull one back to 3-2 in the second set. Jiske, Griffiøen and Aniek van KOOT. They're fighting hard here. Groot and base. Groot serving. That's the sort of error that's bedeviled their game and prevented them from taking control of a match that hasn't seen either side really take it by the scruff of the neck. Really worked that well.
Yeah, great teamwork. Diede the group with a fabulous get. Taking the glory. Fine volley by Griffiøen. That was a super stretch and get. The mix up there. Nice finishing the points off. And again, how many times after they play a great point, along comes that double fault. And there's a feeling in this doubles match which is similar to what we saw in the quad singles. Where you had the favourite, Dylan Alcott, against Andy Lapthorne, and possibly at times just a question of belief. And I just wonder whether BUIS and the group really believe they're going to win this. They keep showing that they can get there, but whenever they got close, they've then fallen away again. Got the game to beat Griffiøen Van Koot. There's no doubt about that. But it just seems when the going gets tough, it is Griffiøen and Van Koot who win the bigger points and the tighter games.
Yeah, it's a mind game, isn't it? And two double faults there gives Griffiona a good break point. Brilliant.
I think a beauty when she times it well. Spinning into the shot, right out in front, full use of her wingspan there. Able to generate some pace on the ball. Three double faults in the game. Needed a group, I'm afraid. Something a bit like a stuck record because the amount of times that three double faults have cost her could well be the difference between winning gold and silver.
So, Griffiun and Van Kurt in the top seeds. Looking a little more relaxed here at 4-2 in the second set.
Feel on occasion with whether or not they'd see it as an embarrassment to use the underarm serve, but at times you just feel get the ball in play because, you know, they played some really good points in that game, yet they've just gifted Griffiön and Van Kuyt the game with only winning one point in it. Just hit a ball.
Yep, see it you. Brilliant. You know, she was hitting that cross court so fluently and then just checked, held it, and then went up the line.
Wait to see what Diede de Groot is like in 4 years' time. As I say, there's so much talent there. Mm. She has a weapon. The weapon is the forehand.
Brings another error from KOOT.
About it being a weapon, it's not quite sculpted into the finished article yet, though.
Consistency. BUIS who puts her forehand in the net. And they just cannot seem to string sort of 3-4 points in a row together here.
Nice.
that brings about a point for 5-2 for Griffiøen and van Kurt. So two really good points to start the game off in three in a row. And first errors. Of claiming a gold medal here, Jiske, Griffiøen and Aniek van Kurt. They lead 5-2, 6-4 the first set. One game will do it. Jiske, Griffiøen, the gold medalist in the women's singles, and the silver medalist Aniek van Kurt. But together, they are one game away from winning the gold medal in the doubles. Marjolein base to serve. It's going to go over the back again. This pair just out rallying, out lasting. Basically, for it. Even though the crit is playing a lot better with her forehand laterally in the late stages of the game of this match. That's better. They've worked their way down the middle of the court throughout the match. And this time, BUIS stinging forehand, splitting the pair. Dino. Two very good forehands, and then that's not always that easy, the short ball.
Yeah, it's difficult to get the timing right because you've got to move quickly up to it, particularly if you want to take it early. On that occasion, not getting the timing right.
It's match point. It's gold medal point. Two points for Jiske Griffioen and Aniek van KOOT to continue the Dutch dominance of the top step of the podium in the Paralympic Games. That's out. The error from BUIS. The celebrations for Jiske Griffioen and Aniek van KOOT. The gold medalists in the doubles. And they've done so by wearing down Marjolein BUIS and Diede de Groot. 6-4, 6-2 in an hour and 49 minutes. BUIS, the gold medalist 4 years ago. But for the first time now, this pair win the doubles title. Jiske Griffioen adds this doubles title to her singles gold medal.
And I think you said it, Gerald, just wearing down their opponents. They're a little more consistent. It's a solid tactical performance of just saying, look, okay, we've beaten you three times this year. See if you can beat us. At the end of the day, BUIS and the group couldn't. To say these two players have been the dominant force in women's Paralympic tennis this year.
Jiske Griffioen and Aniek van KOOT continue their dominance of the doubles court. 6-4, 6-2 winners of a fellow countrywoman, Marjolein BUIS and Diede de Groot.
Yeah, there's a lot of unforced errors in the final. Fascinated to see just how good Diede de Groot is in 4 years' time. Of course, only 19 years of age, she would have learned a lot from that experience. But these two in our picture, as I say, maybe just their experiences in the past counting for a little more. And, well, it was BUIS and de Groot who tried to play the more expansive tennis. They tried to be the more aggressive team, but they had to be right on their A game if they were to beat the top seeds. And sadly for them, it wasn't quite their A game, maybe their B game. Because they did at least push their opponents in terms of getting very close in that first set, but you felt whenever they had the momentum, along came those double faults, and they weren't able to keep momentum for long enough.
One more time, the winners get to hit tennis balls into the crowd. And Griffioen and van KOOT give some joy to some of those spectators. Lovely to see. Good crowd out here at Santa Cruz.
Of course, we saw Gustavo Kuerten in the crowd earlier, and it is one of those sports that you really have to see live and close up. Sometimes television doesn't do it justice. I mean, you see what these players can do, the speed that they hit the ball, how they are able to time their rolls into the ball, and you almost forget that, you know, got to use both arms to roll.
Yep.
And then you then hit a shot. I mean, the coordination skills is something special. The athleticism out there as well. I mean, it's a grueling game now in the modern era. Although BUIS and de Groot will be a little disappointed to have lost the final. You can see they're still smiling. I think coming into this one, would probably have taken a silver. They were the second seed. An epic encounter in the semis against Kimiji. Then Nijuk, 7-5 in the third. An outside chance of gold. It was just too solid, too composed, and too good from this pair.
Jiske, Griffiøen and Aniek van Kooten, the gold medalists in the women's doubles, for the win over their fellow countrywomen, BUIS and de Groot, in straight sets.
Is the stat sheet at the end of that gold medal matchup. Really, it's not one that colours the match. It was all about the tactics and being a little more consistent for Griffiøen and van Kooten. 40 unforced errors for them to go with just four winners, which shows you that they were just saying, right, try and beat us to BUIS and de Groot. And they could, 60 unforced errors for BUIS and de Groot. A few